Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I apologize if my head is looking a little eggy. I just am not very good at doing hair, but I'm definitely working on it. Today I will be reviewing the new ColourPop No Filter Foundation. I have used their concealers before and I love the coverage and everything, so I'm actually excited to try the foundation. I'm on ColourPop's website right now and I'm going to read you guys what they say about this. This is a no filter matte foundation. Developed for the selfie age, our full coverage natural matte foundation delivers flawless looking skin from day to night. The oil-free lightweight formula blends smoothly and is customizable to create the coverage you want. This foundation retails for $12, which is a really good price point for a foundation, but we will see if it's going to be worth $12, or you can just get a Maybelline foundation and it's gonna be full coverage and will stay forever in your life. I'm going to start priming my skin and I'm using the Farsali Rose Gold Elixir and the Unicorn Essence. Wow, you can actually see the ring light on my forehead. Like the entire thing. Honestly, I'm not even like hyping these products up because I'm not sponsored by them or anything. One day, hopefully, but I love Farsali products. The combination of these two work wonders under a foundation. So I got these two colors. This one is Fair 30, and now that I look at it in person and up close, it is very light for me, so I'm going to use just a tad bit. This one is Light 45, and it looks very yellow in the bottle, so I'm gonna see how it looks on my face. We're just gonna mix these two and see where that takes me. Light 45. Two pumps. This one is just, well, that was a lot. Oh, I'm going to look like a ghost. I'm going to need a little bit more foundation because it didn't cover anything really. Ooh, that is okay. Second layer is just what I needed, apparently. I will say I do go for a tad like darker foundations than my own skin tone because this is why. It either feels like too much on your face or it's just not enough coverage. But with the third layer, it did cover my redness, which is my main concern with my face. But okay, still, you see, the pimple's still showing through. It definitely has a natural finish. It didn't my moisture on my face. It's still a little luminous. I didn't purchase the new concealers, but I do have the concealers that they first launched. So this is the old name, Fair 5. Now that the foundation and concealer are on and I'm looking like a true blood actress, I'm just going to contour my face so I can actually look like a human again. So now that the contour is on, I'm just going to use their new setting powder. So the setting powder retails for $9, which is an amazing price point if this is a good setting powder, because you go through setting powders really fast if you do makeup on a regular basis and you crease like me. I crease a lot, like under my eyes, over my eyes. I don't bake necessarily. I just set it with a lot of powder and dust it off immediately because I do have dry skin. I don't want my under eyes to look even drier than it already is. Oh, that looks bright and I love it. It gives that blurring effect and I actually like the powder more than the foundation. I don't know if that's weird. I can see the foundation is already cracking around my nose and I just literally just put it on. So I'm just gonna do a little cute eye look, very simple. I'm just going to keep this video about the foundation and the setting powder. So I'm just going to use the ColourPop Yes Please palette. This is honestly one of the best neutral palettes that I've ever used. It is a warm neutral palette. If you love reds, if you love reddish browns and oranges and yellows, this is for you. So I started with the color Baked Cocktails. That's going to be my transition color. Next on, I'm going to be using this cute salmon color right here called Chance. Next on, I'm going to be using this color right here is called Butter Cake. I'm gonna use this color on my outer corner and just blend it inwards. I'm just gonna blend it with a clean blending brush. Now that our red is on, I'm just going to use this cute color right here. This is called Full Zip. Right on the center of my eyelid, I'm just going to use Silk to Self. I'm just going to do my brows and put some lashes on and probably a little bronzer and blush, and I'll be right back. This is called Speed Dial. This is an ultra matte lipstick. For the highlighter, I'm also going to be using ColourPop. This is Luster Dust in Strobe Glow. This is the final look. I'm just going to step outside for a second and see how the foundation looks in daylight. My initial thoughts are it's not horrible. It's definitely a natural matte finish, as they claim. It is not like a super matte finish like Fenty or Huda Beauty or Marc Jacobs foundation. If you use those foundations, they're definitely on the matter side, which is not the best kind of formula for if you have dry skin. Even the areas of my face that I did not highlight, like here, it still is a little luminous. I will say it did kind of separate around my nose, and I didn't even wear it for a very long time, so I don't know if this is going to be a very long wear foundation. I would say the coverage is like a medium coverage. I definitely will say that it didn't cling onto my dry patches or anything like that, and it was easy to blend, but it's just too watery for me. I'm not crazy about too watery when it comes to foundation. I do like the Maybelline Superstay or Fit Me Matte and Poreless, that formula. It's a little thicker, but this isn't bad. It's just, it wouldn't be my first like go-to foundation. I do prefer their concealer over the foundation. The powder actually worked great for me. It is definitely not too drying, and it is blurring. So even you can see like under my eyes, it brightened my under eyes up a little bit and the center of my face. If you crease like me, when you do this, you basically see like your under eyes, they crease even after the powder. But this one, I didn't crease at all. But this is it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you in the next video. Bye.